Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2088, Find Asterisks in a Filter. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Kim. Kim has a data set and she's using the filter icon up here, and she knows this cool trick where you can search for multiple things. For example, let's say that we wanted to search for a hashtag. All right, so there's all things that have a hashtag in them. Click OK, and then you can open that up and essentially do an OR and search for anything that maybe has an at sign. All right, and in this second step, you want to say add current selection to filter, and what we end up with is anything that has either a hashtag or an at sign. It's beautiful, but that's not what Kim's searching for. Kim is searching for anything that has an asterisk, and this does not work, because when we search for asterisk, you see we're getting all kinds of things that, well, that one has an asterisk, but these don't. What's up with that? And I knew that this would also be a problem if Kim was looking for anything that has a tilde, like this. No matches, or a question mark like that, no matches. All right, and so the whole trick here, these are the three wildcards in Excel. Asterisk is find any number of characters. Question mark is find any character that's one specific length of one. And then the tilde is the tool that says don't treat that wildcard as a wildcard, treat it as a character. So if we're looking for an asterisk, you have to search for a tilde asterisk like that. And we get just the things that truly have an asterisk. Cool. If you want anything that has a question mark in addition, open it up and search for tilde question mark, and it'll get you anything that has a question mark, and we'll add current results to filter. Okay. And then what if you need to find a tilde? Well, it's search for tilde like that, and we'll get anything that has a tilde, add current selection to filter. So now we have anything that has either a question mark or a tilde or a asterisk like that. Now, this can get to some weird things. If you need to define, for example, tilde question mark or tilde, I have a tilde in here, you would have to search for two tildes is looking for the first tilde, so anything that has a single tilde, but then two more tildes says we want only the things that have two tildes in a row, or maybe tilde question mark, and I don't have any of these, I would find anything that had tilde question mark. All right. Kind of crazy. Now, how did I discover that last one? Oh, because I was going to mention that find and replace, if you're going to search for an asterisk, a question mark, or a tilde, you have to do the same thing. But here's the crazy thing. In find what, you have to use the tilde, but when you're replacing, you don't have to use the tilde. So I tried this this thing where I was going to get rid of anything. Let's say I was going to replace all of the question marks with something else. So Control H, and I want to replace any question mark, tilde question mark, with tilde asterisk. Well, I don't need that tilde down there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change every question mark to a tilde asterisk, which is going to be a problem. Like right there. Okay, so we're going to undo that and try it again. So the top one, you need the tilde. The bottom one, though, if I just want to change it to an asterisk, like in that bottom one, the wild card doesn't work, so replace all, and that works. All right, crazy. The other place where this comes in handy is VLOOKUP. If you're looking up something that has a wild card in it, so here I have Walmart, that's what I'm looking for. I'm trying to get a 20 in response to that VLOOKUP, but because that's a wild card, any characters in there, like Walmart, will be the answer that's returned. And that doesn't have to be a single character, it can be Walling World Mart, and it still gets returned as the answer. So in order to get truly Wall Star Mart, you have to look for Wall tilde asterisk Mart. Really, really frustrating. Same thing with a question mark. I should be getting that answer, but because there's a single character in question A mark, it's returning the 30. You have to search for tilde question mark, and then to look for when I search for tilde there, that tilde with not followed by an asterisk is just pretty much ignored, and so that answer is being returned. If you search for two tildes, it'll return the single tilde. Very, very confusing. Now, these tips are in my book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel, 617 Excel Mystery Solved. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to read more about the book. All right, a quick recap. The search box lets you filter for one thing and then filter for another thing, but it fails if you're trying to search for a asterisk, tilde, or a question mark. All right, It either returns everything, in the case of the asterisk, or nothing for the question mark or the tilde. To search for an asterisk, you search for tilde asterisk, or to find a tilde, 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 or to find a question mark, tilde, question mark. That sets up some crazy things, where if you needed to find these three characters, tilde, question mark, asterisk, you'd have to search for tilde, tilde to look for the tilde, tilde, question mark, tilde, asterisk, and it would find those three characters. Now, this also happens in the Find and Replace dialog box, but only in the Find box do you need the extra tilde. Don't put it in the Replace, or it'll be throwing real tildes in there instead of what you're looking for. Also, VLOOKUP or match, you might need to use tilde, 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 asterisk, or tilde, question mark, if you're specifically looking for a tilde, an asterisk, or a question mark. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. So, just to show how the wildcards are supposed to work, if you would search for A asterisk E, you're going to get anything that starts with A and ends with E with any number of characters in the middle. But if you're looking for just three letter words that have an A and then any character in the middle followed by an E, putting the question mark in there says we only want things that have the wildcard being one specific character. Sometimes there might be a use for that.